everyone again. Welcome to the video series of ratio analysis. I hope you are all doing great. So friends, today we will learn about activity ratios or turnover ratios. And we will start with the meaning. Like other different ratios, these ratios will have a meaning by its name. It's activity ratios, which will tell us how active our business is. If we want to know how efficiently a business is operating and how well a business is using its different assets to generate cash, activity ratios will provide us these answers. Now, on what basis we can check efficiency? On what basis we will say that this business is efficient? The answer is sales. Okay, sales is the only proper ways of checking efficiency. So the different ratios that we will find under this head will have sales used directly or indirectly. So different activity ratios that we find to check business efficiency are stock turnover ratio, debtors ratio and debtors turnover, creditors ratio and creditors turnover, fixed assets turnover, current assets turnover and working capital turnover. The first ratio is stock turnover ratio. So how can we check the efficiency of stock? It is only by knowing how many times our stock is being converted in sales. If the stock is not becoming the sales, then it has zero efficiency. It is as good as scrap. So this ratio will tell us how fast our stock is sold. Now, one thing to understand here that if we are having a stock of raw material, its efficiency will be checked on the basis of consumption. And if we are having a stock of finished goods, then its efficiency will be checked on the basis of sales. Okay. So if we try to make the formula, the basic formula will be sales divided by stock. Sales divided by stock. Now, sometimes we will have opening stock and closing stock. So at that time we have to take average stock. Okay? At that time we have to take average stock. And if there is only one stock given, then there is no need to find average stock. Okay. But if we have both, then we have to go with average stock. Now we have one more problem here that we show stock at our cost price, but we show sales with profit. So numerator has profit, but denominator has no profit. So it's a mismatch. So in this case, either we can add profit to stock or we can remove profit from sales. So what we do generally, we remove profit from sales and that becomes our cost of goods sold. So our main formula of stock turnover will be cost of goods sold divided by average stock. Now to find cost of goods sold, we will remove gross profit from sales. Okay, so total sales minus gross profit. That is our cost of goods sold. Or we can find cost of goods sold with another formula, that is opening stock plus purchase expenses less closing stock. Okay. And to find average stock, formula is very simple. Opening stock plus closing stock divided by 2. Now let's do a practical problem. I have a income statement of Sneha Limited here. And total sales given is 20 lakh rupees and gross profit is 15 lakh. So our cost of goods sold will be 5 lakh rupees. Okay. And opening stock is 1 lakh and closing stock is 96,000. So if we put them in this formula, then total sales given is 20 lakh. Gross profit is 15 lakh. So our COGS is 5 lakh rupees. And we have 1 lakh rupees for opening stock and 96,000 for closing stock. So our average stock will be 98,000. And to find stock turnover ratio, we will use this formula. So cost of goods sold, that is 5 lakh divided by average stock, that is 98,000. So our answer will be around 5.10 times. So 5.10 times my average stock is being converted into sales. Now if we go for debtors ratio, then we have to think how can we measure the efficiency of debtors. First thing is that When say debtors, it means not debtors only, but debtors plus bills receivables. Okay. So how can we check the debtors efficiency? It can be checked on two bases. First thing to remember here is debtors are supposed to pay me cash. So the first base will be how quickly they are paying me. If they are taking too long, then I am getting cash late, which suggests low efficiency. And if I am getting payment quickly, then it's good. I can use that cash in other operations. So this will be my first base, how quickly I am getting my money from debtors. Now to find this, I will use debtors ratio. So our formula will be closing balance of accounts receivables, that is debtors plus bills receivables, divided by net credit sales. Okay, net credit sales means total credit sales minus sales returns, and into annual time. Okay, so we have to take annual time here. If the time is given in days, then it will be 365 or 360 days. In months, it will be 12 months, and in weeks, it will be 52 weeks. Now if I go for a practical example, I have a balance sheet that has closing balance of debtors 2,60,000 and bills receivables 75,000. In income statement, sales is 20 lakh, total sales 20 lakh, and credit and cash sales are in ratio of 3:2. And if I check the additional information, third additional information says take 365 days annually. So here in formula, the closing balance of my debtors are 2,60,000 plus 75,000 of BR divided by net credit sales. So 20 lakh total sales, and ratio was 3:2. So 3 divided by 5 into annually 365 days. Okay. So this will be 3,35,000 divided by 12 lakh net credit sales into 365. So approximately it will be 102 days. So debtors are taking 102 days to making me payment. For making me payment. The second base to check debtors efficiency is how many times I am getting paid by debtors. Obviously, if I am getting paid less, then it's less efficient, and if I am getting paid more, then my debtors are generating more cash, which is good. So to check this, I will find debtors turnover. Just like stock turnover, this is debtors turnover. And the formula is just like stock turnover, net credit sales divided by average accounts receivables. This is debtors turnover. So we have to take credit sales, net credit sales, and average accounts receivables. To find that, we will have opening balance of debtors and BR plus closing balance of debtors and BR divided by 2. Now I have 12 lakh rupees for net credit sales as we calculated above, and to find average accounts receivables, I will need opening balance of debtors and BR and closing balance of debtors and BR. Now we already have used closing balance of debtors and BR in above ratio. That was 2,60,000 and 75,000 divided by 2. And for opening balance, I have to check additional information. Here in additional information, the opening balance of debtors and bills receivables is 2,80,000 and 1,00,000 rupees respectively. So opening balance 2,80,000 plus 1,00,000. Okay, so our average accounts receivables will be 3,57,500. Okay, and if we put this amount in debtors turnover formula, then 12,00,000 divided by 3,57,500, and our answer will be 3.36 times. Next is creditors ratio. This ratio is just like debtors ratio, but in reverse mode, because we are supposed to pay to creditors. So this ratio will check our efficiency in making payments to our creditors. Of course, it will be checked on two bases, just like debtors. First, how quickly we are paying. If we are paying late, then it will affect our reputation in the market. And if we are paying too early, then we are not using the credit period enough and losing money early. So we have to make payment just 1 or 2 days before our final date of payment to achieve highest efficiency. Okay, so to find the days we are taking to make payments to creditors, we will find creditors ratio, and formula will be closing balance of creditors plus bills payables divided by net credit purchase into annual time. So here in balance sheet, I have creditors of rupees 50,000, bills payables 60,000. And if I check the income statement for purchase, total purchase given is 4,50,000, and credit and cash purchase are in ratio of 7:3. So here in formula, it will be 50,000 of creditors plus 60,000 of bills payables divided by net credit purchase. So 4,50,000 into 7/10 and into 365 days. So it will be 110,000 divided by 315,000 into 365. That will be around 127 days. And to check how many times we are paying to our creditors, we will find creditors turnover. Formula will be net credit purchase divided by average accounts payables. And to find average accounts payables, opening balance of creditors and BP plus closing balance of creditors and BP divided by 2. So net credit purchase is 3,15,000 divided by average accounts payable. So for that, we have already used closing balance of creditors and bills payables. That was rupees 50,000 and 60,000 divided by 2. And for opening balance of creditors and bills payable, I will have to check additional information. Here is the additional information. Opening balance of creditors, bills payable is 40,000 and 50,000. So 40,000 plus 50,000. So our average accounts payables will be 1 lakh. Okay. So here it will be 3,15,000 divided by 1 lakh. So creditors turnover will be 3.15 times. Now if I check the balance sheet and income statement, the total of current liabilities is 2,85,000. Fixed assets, I have land and building, machine, furniture, vehicles and goodwills. Okay, so this all items will be included in fixed assets, and the total is 10,76,000. Okay, and total of current assets is 7,34,000, and total sales is 20 lakh. And now if we move on to our last three ratios under this head, they are fixed assets turnover, current assets turnover and working capital turnover. If we want to know how well we are using our fixed assets, current assets and working capital to generate cash, these three ratios will be helpful. Okay, so the making of formula is very easy. They all have turnover in their name. That means sales. So sales is in every formula. In fixed assets turnover, we have to divide with average net fixed assets. So average means opening balance of fixed assets plus closing divided by 2, and net means after depreciation. In current assets, average current assets, and in working capital with working capital. So working capital is equal to current assets less current liabilities. So for fixed assets turnover, it will be sales of rupees 20 lakh divided by total of fixed assets. Okay, so I am assuming here that fixed assets given are after depreciation and there is no opening balance of fixed assets. So I have to take the closing balance only. The total was 10,76,000. So my this turnover will be 1.86. Okay. Now sales is 20 lakh. divided by average current assets. So I am not having the opening balance of current assets, so I will use the closing balance only. That was ₹7,34,000. So the answer here will be 2.72. And for working capital turnover, 20 lakhs of sales divided by working capital. So total of current assets was 7,34,000. Current liabilities were 2,85,000. So our working capital will be 4,49,000. So here 20 lakhs divided by 4,49,000. That will be equal to 4.45. Okay. So these were our activity ratios. I hope you all have understood the basics of activity ratios and all the ratios that we find under this head. Okay. So that's it for today. See you in the next one.